Hello, happy Sunday morning, whatever you may be doing. Well, I got up every morning. When I get up, I turn my phone on, and you know, the assistant, and I go, oh, good morning, and it comes back and says, hello, Jem, and then it'll tell me the news. And an item that really interests me today, but first, my condolences to Pelé, the very famous soccer guy's family, who is in palliative care and could die at any time. He is one of all soccer's all greats. But what really interests me is that they had a news item that Taylor Swift's last concert, that some scam artists were asking for $22,000 online for a ticket. And that did my head in. I'm on a disability support pension, and I'm lucky to get $22,000 a year. I am very grateful, though, that, you know, the government in my day does pay welfare, because, you know, 50, 60, 80 years ago, we didn't have this, and you had to fend yourself or you just starved. So I'm very grateful. But what am I going to talk about today? Well, because a lot of you seem to be interested in my supernatural experiences, I thought I would share just another one. Because throughout my life, I'd had different periods, you know, that when I first thought I was a witch, no, I was a child. So this witch period was intermingled with just going to Sunday school. So around about 10 to 14. Then when I was 16, I became a Christian. So from 16 to 26, I became a Christian. Then something happened, and I'm going to tell you two stories, you're lucky. I got involved in Wiccan practices, and I learned about dark forces. And I also learned the power of the mind, and it was a matter of, I can't explain it very well, but it was like a push, a real push, a mental push. And with this mental push, I could do quite a few things. For example, the guy walked past me and I really liked him. I said, put the thought in his head, I really like you. And I got him, believe it or not. I could go to the casino, and I'll give you one time. Just before I was Baha'i, so I'm in my mid, about 36, 37, because I'm married. And my husband and I went to the casino, and we went where there was roulette, and we walked in with our last $20. And each time we had a go 10 times, the first 9 times I said split it between each number, you know, just a matter of like $2. This was only mere increments of $2. So I said split it between the two. The 9 times I got it exactly right. The third time, however, that I got it right, I noticed that they had like security guards coming out looking at me, because what I was doing is I would watch that roulette board go around, and I would push it with my mind on the number that I wanted, and it would stop on that number. And we'd only ever go to, anyway, they were checking me out, couldn't, you know, work it out. And this is in the Brisbane casino. It's actually probably still there on their camera. After the third time of getting it right, the operator said to me, if you get it for the fourth time right, I'm going to go like this. I did it the fourth time. I did it 9 times straight. On the 10th time, I was unsure, so I put it 4 ways because I was really unsure. Well, we hit again. We walked out of there with a few hundred dollars, from $20 to a few hundred dollars. That wasn't the first time I had used those powers in that manner. I had, when I was 26, gone to the Townsville Casino. And again, I had $20. This time, there was a wheel where you have states and states of Australia. So there's the different states. It'd be Queensland, Western Australia, and Queensland and New South Wales. I think Queensland was you'd get your money back. New South Wales was 5-1. Other states, 10-1, 20-1, 40-1 was, I think, the best at the time. Yes, 40-1 was the best, and that was Tasmania and some other state. So if it landed on Tasmania, you got 40 times your bet. But of course, there was a maximum bet that you could put on. You couldn't put like $1,000 on there, do you understand? First go, I walked in my first time and I put it on a 22-1 shot. It won. I walked away with, and again, it was a $2. So I had over $80 and I shouted my 4 mates' drinks. And I still had, after I shouted them all drinks, I still had $60 left. And I'd walked in there with $20. But I wasn't happy with that. So I said, no, I'm going back and I'm going to do it one more time. This time I put it on Tasmania at 40-1. And it hit. So you know the chances of these kind of things happening. I walked out of there with over a couple of $100, only 2 goes. So I walked in with $20, and had 2 goes of $2 bets, and walked out with over a couple of $100. And another time, in the same, when I was 37, here's interesting, I used to buy lotto tickets at the Gold Coast, and it was called the Lucky Black Cat. I had this dream. Now in Australia, our gold Saturday night's gold lotto goes from 1 to 45. Those are the numbers. And then you can pick. So you have to pick 6. To get the top prize, have to pick 6 numbers. But then if you get 5 and a Powerball, because it's too hard, complicated. Australians will know what I'm talking about. Anyway, I had this dream. And this dream told me that I got 5 out of 6 numbers and I just couldn't get the last one. Anyway, I woke up, put my lotto ticket in. That week, that Saturday came, up came my 5 numbers. And the 6th number, I had put 45, which was the last number, and the actual 6th number was 1 at the beginning. So that's how close I came. So sometimes psychics can pick lucky numbers. And since then, I haven't been psychic and won millions of dollars. I have to be truthful, but I've had luck with race horses. I've had for a $2.50 trifecta, I put 2 horses to win. That was a favourite, 10-1. 2 horses for second, which it's again too hard to explain. But virtually only 4 horses I picked for this trifecta. The favourite didn't even come into it. And I won because I put it for half. So I only spent $2.50 for half. I won over $2,500. Now, my luck with gambling, it is not always, as I said, I'm not a millionaire. And I have gone, there's another time I went to the pokies and I was losing and losing and losing, and I was playing Red Baron, for those of you who know Red Baron, and I had a friend with me, and I wanted to hit 25, that would be really greedy. I would have won hundreds of thousands of dollars, okay? I wanted to hit 25 barons. My friend said, don't be greedy, do 15. Well, I got free spin, within free spin, within free spin. 30 red barons came up and I would have got it. So yes, psychics can guess numbers, but if you ask me to guess your numbers, I can't, okay? But I have been lucky, and I used this as a child. My father, being a very violent alcoholic and gambler, I used to come home and he'd be losing, and he would ask me what to pick the winner. And so I would push in my head the name of the horse, and then I'd be petrified in the bedroom whether that horse would win. Anyway, I'm going to give you part two, because this has gone on for long enough. This has been the good ones, and I've had good wins, and with Lotto at the moment, I'm just having little wins that it's just paying for itself. So I'm not winning big, but I'm not losing. I love you, and I'll do a part two and tell you of some horrific experiences. Love yous. Bye.